Okay, students, good morning. Welcome to English class. So far, we have completed Unit 1, A reading, B reading, we have completed. What is the theme of this lesson? The theme of this lesson is personality development. So last classes, we completed first, attitude is altitude. A reading is our attitude is altitude. B reading, every success story is also a story of great failures. Every success story is also a story of great failures. Now, this session, today, let us take the lesson, I will do it. The title of this lesson is I will do it. What I will do it? What is the meaning of this title? What is the meaning of this lesson? I will do it. When we use will, yes, we have the confidence. We have the strong belief that I will do it. It shows the capacity, the capabilities, the work, what we choose. There is none other than I will do it. Will has so much power, willpower we say. When we say I will do it, yes, definitely I will do it. I will speak English only. Suppose if I decide that I speak English, I will speak English. If you use the word I will speak English, yes, definitely I will speak in English only. I will do hard work. Definitely I will do hard work. I will get good marks. Definitely I will get good marks. I will get first rank. I will get first rank. Definitely I will get first rank. So when we use the will, that shows our capacity, our capabilities towards the work we do it. That is the I will do it. Will, it is called determination. Determination, strong will, strong desire, is also called burning desire. I will do it, determination. What do you mean by determination again? A strong will. Strong will. And also burning desire. Burning desire. That is the meaning of determination. So when we use the I will do it. When we use the will, it shows the determination. What determination? Yes, we should have the strong belief. Strong desire. A burning desire. The desire, the burning desire should not make us to sleep. If the burning desire or strong desire will make us sleep, then we will become lazy people. So, that's very, very important. You should have the determination. If there is no determination, it is very difficult to reach our goal. So, that is the meaning of our lesson, I will do it. Here, when we are talking about one person, a famous personality. Let us know about this famous personality in few words. He was very short, very short, but very sharp. I wanted to say one thing. He was very sharp, but very short. So, the intelligent, the cleverness will not appear, will not see in our physical appearance. It is mental appearance, it means it is then our skill oriented, not our physical appearance. Even though you are small, even though you are strong, even though you are colorful, or even though you are colorless, it doesn't matter how your personality, but it matters your brain, your mind. Here we are talking about one person, famous personality. He was very short, but very sharp. His brain works faster than computer. His brain works faster than computer. And very, very talented. See, even his seniors used to ask him many questions. See, seniors are asking junior questions is very, very, what we say, great thing. Actually, juniors will ask questions with seniors. That is our common issue. But here, opposite. Seniors asking questions to junior. The junior, another than one man. We'll talk about later about this personality. And he can grasp many things within no time. That much talented he is. We also don't think that it matters only our. If I am handsome, beautiful only, I will get education. If I am strong enough, I will get education. If I am colorful, I will get education. I am very rich, I will get education. It all not matters. It is matters in our skill, our intelligence, our talent. So this man came from hail from poor family, and his father, this man's father is a English teacher. His father completed English literature and very talented, and he came from poor family. And when he came from poor family, he did hard work from the right beginning. See, he never wasted time. He never roamed here and there. Knowing his economic background, knowing his financial background, he did hard work right from the beginning. So everyone has goal, every student has goal, every student has aim. Suppose if I ask you, what do you want to become? You say, sir, I would like to become an engineer, I would like to become doctor, I would like to become IAS officer, I would like to become a police, I would like to become teacher or professor or lecturer. You may say many your goals. At the same time, here also, this man wanted to study in IIT. Even though he came from poor family, this man wanted to study in IIT. Along with the friends, was preparing for IIT and he was studying. Even though he has a low financial background, lack of financial background, lack of finance, lack of money, he was studying along with the other boys also. He wanted to reach goal. He wanted to study in IIT. He wanted to get the seat in IIT. He wanted to enter in the IIT. Information Technology, which is in Madras. Now it is called Tamil Nadu in Chennai. So, like that, he was right from the beginning goal. That is very, very important. Very, very important. When I study 10th class, when I study intermediate, when I study UG, undergraduation, then I will have the goal. It is not at all good. Right from the beginning, only everybody should have the goal. Every student should have their own goal, how to reach. Then we have the work. Yes, my goal is otherwise aimless. We will become aimless. We will become without any goal. So this man studying, and he got first rank in in school. Along with that, he wanted to apply. So before we go, study in IIT, there should be an entrance test. As you knew already, everything you have to write: entrance test, medical entrance test, engineering entrance test, IIT entrance test, Gurukul entrance test, Navodaya entrance test. When you write entrance test, then if you pass in first rank, in first class, we will be promoted, we will get the seat. At the same time, this man also trying to get seat in IIT. He was preparing to get seat in IIT. He was preparing. Unlike other boys, he is not wasting time. Unlike other boys, he was not chit-chatting with anyone. He was doing hard work, continuous hard work. He was preparing for. He came outside, take the lonely place. He goes to lonely place, prepares to get seat in IIT. That much hard work he was doing, this man. When he is preparing IIT to get a seat in IIT, then he went his relative's house to write the IIT entrance test. We also suppose if I get my exam center in Hyderabad or Vizag or Bangalore, Chennai, then I will go and write entrance test and come back. If I have friends, I will remain with my friend's house, or if I have relatives or well wishers, I will remain there. I will write the test and come back. Same this man also went to his relative's house, spent there and wrote the IIT entrance exams. Days later, he got results. In this results, this man got first rank. So he's very happy. Very, very happy. He got the first rank. He was very happy. Do you know one thing? When we get real happiness, when we become real happiness, do you know that? Our birthday functions, our celebrations, or any festival, when we celebrate any festival, when you celebrate our birthday, when we celebrate any occasion, that is just a temporary happiness. So every year come and go. The real happiness when the student passes in first rank, when student reaches his or her goal, then that is the real happiness. So he is very happy. This man is very happy. He did hard work and he wrote entrance test. He passed in first rank. He was very, very happy. That is the real happiness. That is called real, the meaning of real happiness. But you are the people, you are the student, think that if my favorite hero movie releases, or my favorite star movie, anything releases, if it becomes hit, then we'll be happy, some of them. Some of the students or some of the people, if their near and dear ones, if friends get celebration, if the one friend celebrates the birthday, well, what is happiness you have? Yes, little bit of happiness, okay, you can spend and come back. This is not real happiness. So many students find their happiness in temporarily. So many students find happiness in temporary way. Not this happiness. When this man reaches and this man got first rank, then was very, very happy. His happiness has no boundaries. His happiness has no limitations. Then he went near his father. That time father was reading newspaper, and he went and approached him and said, "Father, I got first rank. I have passed this entrance test. I got first rank." By listening is this news, father was excited, was very happy. My son got first rank. My son got entrance test, and he passed in entrance test. Every one of your parents also. When you reach our goal, when you get first rank, when you get any prize, a reward and award by speaking English or whatever, not only you will get the happiness, but also your parents will get happiness. Everyone talks about you, about your achievement, about your goal. When every people talks about our achievement, our goal, automatically they will get a real happiness. Who are our parents? The parents get real happiness. So then father was very happy, excited. Then one thing is stopping him, because financial background. He has 5 daughters and 2 sons to look after. At the same time, economic background was very poor. Financial background is very poor. Then this man said, "Father, I wanted to go and join IIT in Madras." "My dear boy, well and good. You got first rank. Very good. I am very happy. But our financial position is not allowing us or not allowing you to continue your or to study in IIT. He was disappointed. Boy was disappointed. He came with a lot of happiness. He came with a lot of enthusiasm. He came with a lot of expectations. Many expectations he has. Yes, I got rank. Then I will go and study in Madras. Then he got so much expectation. But all these expectations are collapsed. All his expectations are collapsed because father said our financial background is very poor. So you can't go and continue your studies. You please be here, study in the city only. He was very disappointed. He came. Even though he was very disappointed, one thing we have to observe, my dear students, one thing we have to observe is, even though he was disappointed, he did not scold, he did not murmur, he didn't grumble about parents, especially father. He understood the situation. He understood, this man understood the situation of the family. I have sisters, I have the brothers, my father was working, my father was only working. My father was earning money. How this money is sufficient? How this finance is sufficient for our family? He understood the situation. Even though he was disappointed, but he never scolded, he never grumbled, he never murmured, or he never said any words to his father. When we what we know, adjust for some things, then it will not be in vain. It will not be useless. It will become useful when we adjust something. Adjustments is very, very important. So here, then father said to him, you can study here. Then he wanted to send off his friends along with him, along with this man. So many friends wrote IIT entrance exam. And they also got a seat, they also passed, they also got a rank. Then they wanted to go to IIT Madras. So they were going, and all, along with the friends, they all went to railway station. They went to railway station along with this man. This man wanted to give them send off. Your friends are going. So when they reached railway station, they were talking about their childhood days, their school days, the college days. They are talking about very, very memorable our school days and college and whatever where we spend, especially school days. They were talking. They were sharing happiness with each other. They were sharing their troubles and problems with each other in railway station, one another. They were remembering their childhood days. They were remembering their school days. How they were taught, how they were trained, how they were molded, how they were guided, how they were taken care of. They were talking about this. They were sharing. And one boy said, why can't you come along with us? And he said, with a lot of pain, I don't have that much financial support to come along with you. By hearing these words, he was very, very happy. See, my dear students, if you get a seat, you wanted to study in famous reputed colleges on universities, if you get the seat, if you are not going and studying there, how will you feel? You feel very sad. Here everyone is sharing his happiness, their happiness, everyone sharing, everyone talking about their future, everyone talking about, and not only they are talking about their past life, but also friends were talking about their future, their nest hostel, academics, groups, about groups, after completing that, which one you wanted to take, which group you want to take, their hostel life, they were all talking this. When all these people are talking, he became one this man stood motionless without any movement, without any movement, because he was not going. Friends are going. So when they were talking about all the things, their future, about their future, about their past, about their future, this man was standing motionless, no movement, no movement. So when they're talking, when they finished talking, then train started. So everyone gave send off, and all his friends got into the train. All his friends got into the train, and he sent them off, and he said goodbye to the his friends. He waved his hand like that, and everyone was going, crying, getting emotion, and standing like that in the railway station, Mysore city. Friends were going in train. They were waving hand. This man was standing. This man was standing there, just without any movement, just looking at them, saying bye. Tears rolled out of his eyes, crying. So much bitterness. He was feeling very sad. He was able to cry also. That time, it is 1963, month of June and July, the season, monsoon season. That time, monsoon season. So there will be a little drizzling, just a little rain. The time it was raining, so he was standing there. He was not going anywhere. Lot of pain. All his friends are going. Nicely, they wanted to study in their IIT, and they went away. They want to reach their goal, but this man stood here only. Even though it was raining, he stood like this, motionless, without any movement. Was crying. Very sad situation. With many, no one can get like this situation. Very, very important. Why? Because he too wanted to go along with them. He too wanted to study along with them. He too wanted to join in IIT along with them. But the position was very, very sad. So after some time, then he came back and continued his studies in city only. Father joined him one of the college in the Mysore city, and he continued. He did not give up. Here one more thing also, he didn't give up. My friends went to join in IIT, but he didn't give up. Yeah, that's what I always say. As long as we are talented, we need not afraid of anything. We need not to do any we need not to try to commit any suicide. That is, the talented is very, very important. Talented is very, very important. He is very clever student. This man is very, very clever student. Very clever. Even though he did not go there, but he studied there along with according to the instructions of his father, and he studied and he continued his education step by step. He climbed the Mount Everest, and he reached his goal. One more thing is he never looked for any comforts or personal comforts. This is very, very important, my dear students. Personal comforts. What is that? Personal comforts, which means lack of adjustments. Personal comforts. If there is AC class only, I will study. Otherwise, I won't study. If there are fans only, if the classroom structure is very well only, I will study. Otherwise, I won't study. I will run away. He didn't think like that. He never thought like that. He never looked for his personal comforts. He did hard work. He did hard work, and he never bothered. He never bothered personal comforts and luxurious life and comfortable life. That's why he reached his goal. You are the students also. When there is, when we feel comfort only, when everything is well planned and everything is structured, everything is well, classroom is well structured, AC is there, then only I will study is wrong, it is wrong. My dear student, I would like to say one thing. What is the greatness of to become a successful person? Do you know that? Now there are two various kinds of students are there. Listen, all of you. Various kinds of students are there. Some students will study in government, not some, almost all some students will study in government school. Students who are studying government school, their economical background, their financial background is very poor. Students are studying in private schools. Private schools, maybe they are middle class or rich or above average or more than rich. We're not talking about the not talking about their divisions, but some of the students will study in government school, some of the students studying in private schools, and some of the students studying international schools also. International schools, if we talk about international schools, you know what is the structure of international schools? Central AC, and everything is in their hand only, very very comfortable. There they're studying. When they study like that, so when they're getting good marks and rank, what is the greatness? Now we're talking about the students who are studying in a government school where there is no AC, sometimes no fan facilities also. Sometimes there will be no proper roof. Proper buildings, and some of the students will study under the tree. Some of the students study under the tree and beside the road, but they are also reaching their goal. They are also getting the good marks. That's what we should not always see for comforts. This man also, he did not bother of comforts. He did hard work. Then step by step, he did hard work. Even though in spite of problems also, he continued his journey. At the last, he found one company is called Infosys Company. Now, Infosys Company, he became the founder of Infosys Company. Is none other than, do you know who is that? Who is the person? Narayana Murthy, Sudha Chandra Narayana Murthy, wife Sudha Murthy. So he is the person, one who found the Infosys Company. One day, he spent all the day in the railway station, crying and feeling sad about his future. But at last, he started and he founded the company's Infosys Company, Narayana Murthy. So that is a story of Narayana Murthy. From the beginning onwards, I have been repeating, the man is none other than Narayana Murthy, the founder of Infosys Company. Now, once he hailed from poor family, now he was able to give lakhs and lakhs of people employment opportunities. That is called I will do it, the lesson. Now first this man said I will do it. He took the strong decision, I will do it. At the last, he proved, Narayana Murthy proved that I did it. So he did it and he found the Infosys Company. Nowadays many are doing job, many are working in the this company, Infosys Company, one who founded by Narayana Murthy. Narayana Murthy not only business oriented businessman, but also used to meet the people who are in need. He used to help the people. He used to start the orphanages. So this is the story of I will do it, the written by Narayana Murthy. If we have this kind of attitude, positive attitude, and this kind of hard work and commitment and determination, you also reach our goal. Thank you.